Well, last year we had an early onset of flu. The season kind of struck pretty early, with cases spiking in November, as opposed to usually they see it in January and February spiking. And that makes getting the flu shot even more important this year. And joining us now is Dr. Neha Voyas from the Cleveland Clinic to explain what we can expect from this year's flu strain. And we also have Nurse Brian Holbrook with us as well. And I am going to be your volunteer to get the flu shot today. So let's talk first, Doctor. As I mentioned, just as I was introducing you, it seems that the flu hit a little early last year.
It did. And we probably anticipate the same thing this year. So that's why it's very important and relevant to get your flu vaccine as soon as you can.
Okay, so when it strikes, we also want to know when you get that shot, does it still take about 2 weeks to take effect?
It does, and you want to anticipate that. So certainly try to get it 2 weeks before you know you're going to be around a group of people or in a place where there may be some influenza virus circulating.
Who should get the flu? The shot, rather.
That's a great question. Everybody over the age of 6 months is eligible to get the flu vaccine.
And you see it more importantly, let's talk about how, well, people say, oh, the flu, it's not that bad, you can get through it. But the deaths from people dying from the flu, it doesn't have to happen if they are immunized against it.
Yes, exactly. The days missed from work, the hospitalizations, and even the death from influenza is very real. And that's why it's very important to get the flu vaccine and protect those around us.
Let's talk about the differences between flu and just a cold. What are some of those symptoms of the flu?
Yes, with the flu, you generally see a fever and body aches and chills and feelings of fatigue. Versus when you have a cold, it's more just upper. It may hit your sinuses. It may hit your throat.
The flu symptoms that you were just describing kind of sound like COVID a little bit too.
Yes, they do, and they can oftentimes be indistinguishable from each other.
And it's important to get tested too, to make sure you say don't have COVID, or if you know what you have.
Yes.
There are a lot of flu tests out there too.
Yes, there are.
So how about the COVID shot? I know a lot of people are asking, can you get that shot if you're interested with the flu shot?
Yes, you can get both of those simultaneously, one on each arm.
And are you seeing many reactions to flu shot, the COVID shot?
Well, we do have the typical soreness at the site, sometimes a low-grade fever, but certainly those symptoms are less than what you get with the actual influenza virus or the COVID virus.
And as we keep saying, you know, let's reiterate it because it just was worth repeating. What should you do if you are sick, whether you know or don't know if it's a cold, COVID, the flu, a different virus? We know strep's going around too. What are some of your recommendations for people if they're not feeling well?
We say stay away from others. That's the best thing. And take care of yourself and make sure you stay hydrated and get plenty of, take time for yourself.
Mm-hmm. All right, Brian, you were here last year doing this, and that's why we brought you back. Because it was painless, I did not feel a thing, and you did a great job with the shot. So you're going to administer this to me again. What is your recommendation? I need to relax, don't stress my muscle.
Just relax,
right?
Don't tense up your arm. So, okay. And I'll go on and tell you 1, 2, 3, and then.
It wasn't bad at all. And usually you do have like a little bit of a pain, stiff arm for a couple of days. Whatever you did, do again today because I didn't feel anything. It was fine.
All right. Just relax your arm.
Okay.
I'm going to clean you off here.
All righty. Brian, where you are both with the Cleveland Clinic.
Yes, I work in the emergency department.
Are you seeing people coming in with kind of these illnesses?
We're starting to. We've seen a couple COVID cases. Flu, we're starting to see a little bit, but not anything drastic yet. That's my pen.
All right, he's getting all of his stuff ready. All right, and so in flu shots, you can get those at your doctor's office. A lot of the drug stores offer them well. Also to Walgreens, CVS, a lot of the pharmacies.
Yes, many employers also offer them.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready when you are.
Because you're the important one.
Okay. I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
I'm ready when you are.
All right, I'm ready. Let's go. Let's do this. See if I flinch.
All right, poke.
Not bad at all.
Wonderful.
Easy breezy.
Good job.
Is there such a thing as kind of working it out or?
Just, yeah, afterwards, you just don't want to put your Band-Aid on.
Thank you. I hope I get a sucker too.
No, no smiley face Band-Aid either.
Okay. Thank you, Brian,
as
always.
You're quite welcome.
Painless. And this will help. I'll be protected from the flu this entire flu season.
Yes.
This will last up until?
About April or so, April or May.
This is the time to schedule it now.
Yes, it is.
Get your flu shot. Great to see you, doctor. Thank you for coming back
this
year. This was the same team that was here with us last year when we did this, so we appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right.